Problem number 14, solve radical equations. The formula for the radius of a cylinder is given by the square root of v over pi h is equal to r. The height of a certain cylinder is 11 centimeters and the radius is 4 centimeters. Use the given formula to find the volume of the cylinder and use 3.1416 as an approximation for pi. Okay, again. First, I would underline the most important information. So obviously we are going to need this formula. And then we are given the height of this cylinder, which is 11 centimeters, and also we are given the radius, which is 4 centimeters. And they want us to use 3.1416 for pi. So the question is to find the volume of the cylinder, and the volume is right here in the formula. So what I'm going to do next is I'm going to solve this formula for the variable that I'm looking for v. If I would start plugging in, I might going to get confused with all those numbers and don't know what to do. So I have the square root of v over pi h is equal to r, and I'm going to solve for v. So I need to get rid of the radical, and I can do that by raising it to the power of its index, which is 2 on both sides. On the left, this cancels out, and I have v over pi h equals r squared. And now solving for v, I have to get pi and h to the other side. Because this is division, I'm going to do the opposite, which is multiplication by pi h, and that should take care of the problem. So on the left side, the pi and the h in the denominator cancel out with the pi and the h in the numerator, and v is by itself, my volume. And on the right side, I just have r squared pi h. And it doesn't really matter in which order I write them because this indicates multiplication, and multiplication is commutative, so I can switch the variables around without getting a different answer. So now I'm ready to plug in my actual numbers into my formula. I'm going to plug in 4 for the radius, which is r, so 4 squared. Then for pi, I am going to use 3.1416, and for h, I have 11. Now 4 squared is 16. And because I might need a calculator to do the decimal, I'm first going to multiply the 16 and the 11 together. That gives me 176. And then I am going to use a calculator to do this last calculation, and I get 552.916. There's a 2. 9216. If I round to one decimal place, I get 552.9. And usually in word problems, especially these types of word problems, I need units. In this case, it's centimeters. And some of you might know that volume indicates cube. But if you don't, then you should use units throughout your problem. And for example, right here, the 4 indicates radius, which was in centimeters. And the 11 also had a unit centimeters. And now when you squared that, you ended up with 16, but centimeters squared. And then the 11 still had the centimeters. So now when we multiplied the 16 and the 11 together, the centimeters right here became centimeters cube. And that should make clear why your answer should be cubic centimeters. So 552.9 cubic centimeters is your final answer for this problem.